Hello children, today in mathematics for standard 4, we are going to learn a new lesson, division part 2. Now let's revise what we have done in part 1. Divide 56 notebooks equally among 7 students. How many will each get? So let us carry out 56 divided by 7. 56 if we divide it by 7, 7 8s are is 56, we get the remainder 0. So 56 is the dividend, 7 is the divisor, 8 is the quotient and 0 is the remainder. So final answer is each one gets 8 notebooks. Word problems. Solve the following problems. If 49 seedlings are to be planted in a garden in rows of 7 saplings each, how many such rows will be made? We write the statements. Total seedlings is equal to 49. Number of saplings in a row is equal to 7. Total number of rows, that is what we have to find out. So we'll arrange it in vertical arrangement. 49 divided by 7. We have to take one digit at a time. 7 zeros is 0. 4 minus 0 is equal to 4. We bring the 9 down by using an arrow. So 49 will go how many times in 7 times table? Yes, it will be 7 sevens is 49. 9 minus 9 gives us 0 and 4 minus 4 is also 0. So our quotient will be our final answer when we get the remainder 0. So our final answer will be 7 rows of 7 saplings each will be made. We'll see one more example. There are 87 beads. How many necklaces of 9 beads each can be made and how many beads will be left over? So first we start by writing the statements. Total beads is equal to 87. A necklace contains 9 beads. How many necklaces of 9 beads can be made and how many beads will be left over? This is what we have to find out. So we'll solve it by dividing 87 by 9. Again, we start using one digit at a time. 9 zeros is 0. 8 minus 0 is equal to 8 and we bring the 7 down by using an arrow. Now 87 will go how many times in 9 times table? Yes, directly we cannot do it. So we have to take a number which is less than 87. So 9 9s is 81. 7 minus 1 is 6 and 8 minus 8 is 0. So final answer is 9 necklaces will be made and 6 beads will be left over. Now let's learn how to do division of 3 digit number by a 1 digit number. We'll see few examples. 484 divided by 4. Here also we begin by taking 1 digit at a time. 4 will go how many times in 4 times table? Yes, it will be 1. So 4 ones is 4. 4 minus 4 is equal to 0. We bring the 8 down using an arrow. 8 will go how many times in 4 times table? Yes, it will be 2. 4 twos is 8. 8 minus 8 is equal to 0. Again, we use an arrow and bring the 4 down. 4 ones is 4. 4 minus 4 is equal to 0. So hence, when 484 is divided by 4, we get the answer 121. How is this written? Dividend is equal to 484. Divisor is equal to 4. Quotient is equal to 121. And remainder is equal to 0. We'll see one more sum. 815 divided by 2. Again, we started by using one digit at a time. 8 will go how many times in 2 times table? Yes, it is 4. 2 fours is 8. 8 minus 8 is equal to 0. We bring the 1 down using an arrow. Now 1 cannot go in 2 times table. So it will be 2 zeros are is 0. 1 minus 0 is equal to 1. Again, we bring the 5 down using an arrow. So 15. 15 will go how many times in 2 times table? So we have to take a number which is less than 15 in 2 times table. So 2 sevens are is 14. 5 minus 4 is equal to 1 and 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. Now here in this sum, we have got a remainder as 1. So our final answer will be dividend is equal to 815, divisor is equal to 2, quotient is equal to 407 and remainder is equal to 1. Now we shall solve few word problems. Madhu has 300 rupees note. 6 10 rupee notes and 9 1 rupee coins totaling rupees 369. How should she divide it equally between Meena, Beena and Nagesh? So again we divide 369 by 3. We take one digit at a time. 3 ones are is 3. 3 minus 3 is 0. We bring the 6 down. 6 will go how many times in 2? 3 times table? Yes, it will be 2. So 3 twos are is 6. 6 minus 6 is 0. We bring the 9 down using an arrow. 9 will go how many times in 3 times table? It will be 3 threes are 9. 9 minus 9 is 0. So final answer is rupees 123 is equally divided between Meena, Beena and Nagesh. 800 divided by 2 is equal to how much? 2 fours are is 8. 8 minus 8 is equal to 0. We bring the 0 down using an arrow. 2 zeros are is 0. 0 minus 0 is equal to 0. Again, we bring the 0 down which is left using an arrow. 2 zeros are is 0. 0 minus 0 is equal to 0. So when we divide 800 by 2, the dividend is equal to 800 and divisor is equal to 2. Quotient is equal to 400 and remainder is equal to 0. We'll see one more example. Divide 900 by 6. So 9 will go how many times in 6 times table? Yes, it will be 6 ones are 6. 9 minus 6 is equal to 3. We bring the 0 down, 30. 30 will go how many times in 6 times table? It will be 5. 6 5s are 30. 0 minus 0 is 0. And 3 minus 3 is also 0. Now the 0 is left. We have to bring that 0 down using an arrow. So 6 zeros are is 0. 0 minus 0 is 0. So the dividend is equal to 900, divisor is equal to 6, quotient is equal to 150 and remainder is equal to 0. Now children, you must always remember this while dividing. In case a number is divided 0 times, write the 0 in the correct place in the quotient, because in division 0 also has value. Solve the following problems. If a hostel has 132 students with 3 students in one room, in how many rooms are the students staying? So first we write the statements. Total students is equal to 132. Students in one room is equal to 3. 132 students in how many rooms, that we have to find out. So we do the division. 132 divided by 3. Again, we start with the first digit. 3 zeros are is 0. 1 minus 0 gives us 1. We bring the 3 down using an arrow. 13 will go how many times in 3 times table? It cannot go directly, so we have to take a number which is less than 30. So for this, children, you have to know your tables thoroughly. So 3 fours are is 12. So 3 minus 2 is 1 and 1 minus 1 is 0. Again, we use the arrow and bring the 2 down. 12 will go how many times in 3 times table? Yes, it is 4. So 3 fours are is 12. 2 minus 2 is 0 and 1 minus 1 is 0. So our final answer is the students are staying in 44 rooms. We'll see one more example. How many bouquets can be made from 340 flowers with 8 flowers in each bouquet? How many flowers will be left over? So let us write the statements first. Total flowers are given to us is 340. Flowers in one bouquet is equal to 8. Bouquets made by 340 flowers, we don't know how much, we have to find out. And flowers left over also, we have to find out. So now again we do division. 340 divided by 8. We start dividing one digit at a time. Now 3 is smaller and 8 is bigger, so it will be, 3 cannot go directly in 8 times table, so it will be 8 zeros are 0. So 3 minus 0 gives us 3 and we bring the 4 down using an arrow. 34 will go how many times in 8 times table? Again you have to take a number which is less than 34. So it is 8 fours are is 32. 4 minus 2 gives us 2 and 3 minus 3 is equal to 0. Again we use an arrow and we bring the 0 down, so we get 20. Now 20 will go how many times in 8 times table? Again it cannot go directly, so we have to take a number which is less than 20. So 8 twos are is 16. And now we have to solve this. Now 0 minus 6 is not possible, which we have already learned in subtraction. So what we have to do? We have to borrow. So we'll take 1 from the tens place, in the units place. So here the 0 will become 10. And since we have borrowed 1 from the units place, the number which is before 2 is 1. So 10 minus 6 is 4 and 1 minus 1 is 0. So final answer is 42 bouquets can be made by 340 flowers and 4 flowers are left over. I hope so you have understood the lesson and enjoyed watching the video. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe my channel and stay tuned for more videos. Bye-bye.